This tiny teach is about explaining the equation for cellular respiration or aerobic energy production. Given the importance of ATP to the maintenance of cellular activity, it's surprising how little ATP is present in a cell at any time. It's estimated that a bacterial cell contains no more than 1 second worth of ATP, and that ATP molecules are used almost as quickly as they're regenerated. The average human at rest would use about 99 pounds of ATP in a day, but at any given time, there's less than 0.035 ounces of ATP present in the human body. It's estimated that every second in every cell, about 10 million ATP molecules are regenerated and an equal number break down to transfer energy to the activities of the cell. To produce ATP, we break open the bonds of glucose or other fuels and release the electrons and the energy they carry and transfer as much of that energy as we can to the ATP molecule. Our equation starts with glucose. Glucose feeds into the first step of cellular respiration or aerobic energy production, glycolysis. In glycolysis, we begin to split the glucose molecule open to release the energy and the electrons. We then go to the bridge between glycolysis and the Krebs cycle. At both the bridge and the Krebs cycle, carbon dioxide on the product side is produced. We basically moved the 6 carbons of glucose into the 6 carbons of carbon dioxide. Oxygen, which is also on the reactant side, is the final member of the electron transport chain. The electron transport chain is the final step in aerobic energy production. This is where the last of the energy is extracted from the electrons. Oxygen is what receives those electrons, and that oxygen, along with the electrons, comes together with hydrogen to produce water, which is on the product side. So that's it. Everything's balanced and everything has a purpose.